Hi friends, welcome to Thinkers IAS. In this video, let us know about Chandragupta II. He ruled between AD 380 to 412. The reign of Chandragupta II saw the high water mark of the Gupta Empire. He extended the limits of the empire by marriage, alliance and conquests. Chandragupta married his daughter Prabhavati with a Vakataka prince who belonged to Brahmana caste and ruled in central India. The prince died and was succeeded by his young son, so Prabhavati became the virtual ruler. He exercised indirect control over Vakataka kingdom. This gave him advantage. Then conquered western Malwa and Gujarat, which had been under the rule of the Sakas, which gave him the western sea coast famous for trade and commerce. Iron pillar inscription fixed near Qutub Minar in Delhi belongs to him. Chandragupta II adopted the title of Vikramaditya, which had been first used by an Ujjain ruler in 58 BC as a mark of victory over the Sakas. This is the iron pillar of Delhi, which features an inscription of this king Chandra, identified as Chandragupta II. Now, the following points are very important. Court of Chandragupta II had scholars including Kalidasa and Amarasimha. Chinese pilgrim Fa Xin from 399 to 414 AD visited India. Now, let us look into the fall of the empire. The successors of Chandragupta II had to face an invasion by the Huns from Central Asia in the second half of the 5th century AD. Invasion by the Huns from Central Asia in the second half of 5th century. Advantage for Hun invaders were they excelled in horsemanship and used stirrups made of metal. This attack weakened the Guptas and drastically reduced the extent of Gupta Empire at the beginning of the 6th century. Huna succeeded by Yasodharman of Malwa and set up in 532 pillars of victory commemorating his conquest of almost the whole of northern India. It was a severe blow to the Gupta Empire. During later phase of Gupta dynasty, there was a rise of feudataries. It was due to the fact that North and Southeast Bengal governors became independent. Later, Guptas of Magadha established their power in Bihar. Maukharis rose to power in Bihar and Uttar Pradesh and had their capital at Kannauj. It seems that by 550, Bihar and Uttar Pradesh had passed out of Gupta hands. The ruler of Valabi established their authority in Gujarat and western Malwa. After the reign of Skanda Gupta, that is in AD 467, hardly any Gupta coin or inscriptions has been found in western Malwa and Saurashtra. They found it difficult to maintain a large professional army on account of the growing practice of land grants for religious and other purposes. They found it difficult to maintain a large professional army on account of the growing practice of land grants for religious and other purposes, which was bound to reduce their revenues. During the later phases, there was a decline in the foreign trade. Various indicators which shows this decline include the migration of a guild of silk weavers from Gujarat to Malwa in AD 473, adoption of non-productive professions. After the middle of the 5th century, the Gupta kings made desperate attempts to maintain their gold currency by reducing the proportion of pure gold in it. All this shows there was reduced prosperity and decline in foreign trade. That's it for today. Please download the PDF slides of ancient history video series till now. There are totally 43 videos which we have covered in our previous sessions. Please click on the link in the description below. This PDF is very useful for UPSC IAS prelims examination. Also, subscribe to Thinkers IAS YouTube channel and click on the bell icon to receive notifications. Thank you.